With boldness, let us approach the throne of grace, that we may receive mercy and find grace in the timely help. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Spirit of God's grace and goodness. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your Spirit, O Lord, we pray, imbue us powerfully with spiritual gifts, that he may give us a mind pleasing to you, and graciously conform us to your will. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, let us pray to you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Wishing to determine the truth about why Paul is being accused by the Jews, the commander freed him and ordered the chief priests and the whole Sanhedrin to convene him. Then he brought Paul out and made him stand before them. Paul was aware that some were Sadducees and some Pharisees, so he called out before the Sanhedrin, "My brothers, I am a Pharisee, the son of Pharisees. I am on trial for hope in the resurrection of the dead." When he said this, a dispute broke out between the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and the group became divided. The Sadducees say that there is no resurrection or angels or spirits, while the Pharisees acknowledge all three. A great uproar occurred, and some scribes belonging to the Pharisee party stood up and sharply argued, "We find nothing wrong with this man. Suppose the spirit or an angel has sworn to him." The dispute was so serious that the commander, afraid that Paul would be torn to pieces by them, ordered his troops to go down and rescue Paul from their midst and take him into the compound. The following night, the Lord stood by him and said, "Take courage, for just as you have borne witness to my cause in Jerusalem, so you must also bear witness in Rome." The word of the Lord. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to you, Lord, my Lord, are you? O Lord, my allotted portion of my cup. You are the ones who hold fast my lot.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
Therefore my heart is glad, and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul in the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope.
You will show me the path of life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights of your right hand forever.
Keep me safe, O God, my hope.
Lord, be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to the Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, "I pray not only for these, but also for those who will believe in me through their word, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as sense, that's what God does to us sometimes. He throws things both within us and causes contentions within us. Because we need to deal with those issues. We need to deal with those things that, in a sense, aren't really of Christ, aren't really of God, aren't really of this world. They're not of the essence. And then we get in fights and bitterness and all the other stuff. And Jesus is looking back and saying, why are you on? It's about compassion, mercy, tenderness, love. And you're worried about so many other things that aren't part of me. And so somehow the Lord, though, is there trying to unite us. And it's not that there's a division per se, because ultimately we're all held in God. In some sense, both the Pharisees and the Sadducees believe in God. It's not like they don't. It's not like they don't have good people. It's just sometimes we get wrapped up in too many other things. And it's coming back to the reality of how do we, in a sense, find that which we can stand upon, which is the love of God, the unity that God brings, even in our divisions. And so this thing just asks God to help us to see that. And really, ultimately, Christ came to show us who the Father is. And it's a continual growth for all of us to enter into that growth, to know who that Father is. And eventually, it wakes us up to a deeper reality that unites us all. So ask God to help us find that. And at this time, we bring our knees to our gracious God. For Pope Francis, may the Lord continue to safeguard and guide him as he shepherds us in the ways of faith, hope, and charity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, may the grace of God affect them in the desire for doing his will in their service. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For countries suffering from the effects of the civil war, or even virus, may the Prince of Peace grant them all lasting peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our communities, may the Lord bless us and sustain us in our life of discipleship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sake of the name of Saint Grace and those who have died, that they may share in the risen of Christ in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We bring our own needs to God. For these needs we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Most gracious God, hear our prayers and answer them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation, with your goodness we have this bread we offer to you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be you, Lord God of all creation, with your goodness, we have this wine we offer to you. Fruit of the vine, the work of human hands, will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, send down your spirit and all like the dewfall, that they may become for us, body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time you were betrayed, passion, he took bread, giving thanks over it, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood of the new eternal covenant, which we pour out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of the resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your fellowship for the being of presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray for taking the body of Christ and gathering it one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope Gerald, our bishop, all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints and thieves throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs of your life and grace and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we pray to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we wait for us to hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God, the glory of God, is now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace and you might be saved in you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
We offer you the peace of those who family the Lord and the high peace of others. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I do not believe that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul shall be.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, by whose mysteries you have cleansed and nourished, grant we pray that this sacrament which you give us may bring everlasting life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go.